was the rallying call for the demonstration dubbed Occupy Harambee Avenue. Sparked by the death of 28 people in Mandera County, with crosses to symbolize the deaths that occurred in the hands of the terrorists. The demonstrators camped outside the president's office, demanding for more action from the head of state on matters security, anger evident in their faces.
All they're doing is releasing press conferences, releasing statements, lighting candles, buying flowers. Tell me, I mean, somebody who's lost a father, a husband, a son, a mother, a daughter, how many candles will you light for them to come back?
If the president and his deputy, who was speaking the other day, are the people who are protecting failures like Kimaiyo and Ole Lenku, they should go home. Uhuru and Ruto should go home if they cannot ensure the security of Kenyans.
The man has not fired a single person since he became president. He told Gishangi to resign. If he's afraid of firing Kimaiyo, tell Kimaiyo to resign then.
Bungoma Senator Boni Halwale joined in on the protest, demanding the sacking of Interior Cabinet Secretary Joseph Ole Lenku and the Inspector General of Police David Kimaiyo.
Ile mili ya watoto 28, young professionals.
Yes.
None of them was a son of a minister.
Yes. Exactly.
None of
yes.
them was a son of an MP.
Absolutely.
None of them was a son of a senator.
Yes. Yes.
Hao ni watoto wa wanyonge.
Yes.
The protesters also lay blame on the legislators, who they say are not playing their role adequately on the matter.
The legislators should not come to the street with us and shout that Ole Lenku should go home. That's not what they should do. They should go to parliament and make declarations there.
The protesters have vowed not to relent until Kimaiyo and Lenku are kicked out of office. Esther Kahumbi, The Big Question.